Hi viewers, welcome to my another video. Today's video, I let you know how we can troubleshoot an active fault code of Komatsu wheel loader. Yesterday, I worked at a machine and that machine was the Komatsu WA470-5 wheel loader. There was appeared a fault code and machine lost the power when this code appeared. I went on the site and I solved the problem by using the workshop manual. Therefore, I want to share my experience which I got during this problem. So how I solved this problem and make the video. So these all things I want to share with you people. After checking the code from the computer screen, I unfolded my workshop manual and I try to check the description of that code. So now you can see the screen in front of you. Here is the, you can, this is our code ADA1KA. So description of this code is here. Description is this: number one injector solenoid valve system is disconnected. It means our the coil of injector is disconnected. So what is the effect of this? So what will affect on the machine? So engine output become lower. So I already told you when this code is appeared, our power in machine's power lost. So here you can see, here is this one area. This is our rectification method of this code and this one is a diagram of this code. These two can see. So here are three steps. Number one, there are three steps we need to perform to rectify code and we check where is the problem. So first I talk about the number one. So number one, we check the coil of the injector. So what I have to do? For it, we turn off the starting switch off and disconnect the connector number CN1. So this one is our connector number one. We disconnect this one and put our multimeter. Multimeter leads number one and pin number two and check the resistance of this coil. So this is written. So we check the this pin number one, connector number CN1, pin number one, pin number two, we check the resistance. So our resistance should be 0.4 to 1.4 ohm. This one is our first step. So what is the second step? This is our second step. Second step is our to disconnection in wiring harness. We need to check maybe our these wire maybe have disconnected or broken. So this number two is our test. Starting switch off and disconnect the connector L83 and CN1. So we have to disconnect this connector and disconnect the disconnector from here. So first we check what I have to do. This test mean we have to check one multimeter lead put here and second one we put multimeter lead is here and check the continuity. Secondly, what I have to do, connector number L83 pin number 24 and connector number 1 pin number 2. I think this one is written wrong. Here is a pin number 1. This is a pin number 1. So we check one multimeter lead is here and one multimeter later is and check the continuity between these. If wire is broken, if any wire is broken, the resistance should be maximum 1 mega ohm.
If this wire is broken, the resistance will be 1 mega ohm. So what we, our third test is this one. Check the defective engine controller. For it, what we have to do, we turn starting switch off position, disconnect the connector number L83, we disconnect this connector from the engine controller, from the ECM. So what I have to do, we check the L83 pin female pin number 14 to pin number 20. So what we have to do, we remove this connector and put our multimeter leads pin number 14 and pin number 24 and check the resistance. If the resistance is this, then our, if resistance this, it means our, actually this resistance is of this one. So if resistance is this one, it means our continuity is okay, our coil resistance is okay, it means then problem is our ECM. Let's, we have to go back to the our machine and we have to perform this test. So viewers, this is my first test. I am going to check the resistance of the coil. I remove the connector number 1 CN1 from the coil and I put in other connectors, and to that connector I fix my multimeter two leads on that area, and I put my multimeter knob on the resistance side. Okay, so you can see here is a connector number 1 I removed, and I put another connector and I put my leads on the both side of the coils. So my resistance of this coil is a 1.0 ohm. It means the coil is okay, its resistance is okay. So my first test is completed. So my resistance is okay, my coil resistance is okay, it means my coil is a good one. So you can see again here the resistance of the coil is 1.0 ohm. So first test is complete now. So viewers, you can see now I am going to check the continuity from the injector connector up to this engine controller. Okay, so engine controller, you can see here are written the numbers of the wire number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and here is a 11, this one is 11, this wire is 12, 13, 13, and this one 14 number wires. Okay, so 14 number wire is a plus, and here you can see this is a 21. This wire is written 21. This is a 21, this is a 22, this down is a 23, and this one is wire 24. So I check the continuity from the injector connector up to this controller connector. I'm going to check the wiring continuity. Okay, so here you can see it also. Okay, so here I written the wire number. So I check the wire number of 14 and 24 of. So here you can see this wire is coming from the injector connectors. Okay, I put on the pin number 1, and this one is also here, and now this one I am putting here. So you see the sound. Okay, so this continuity is okay. Now I am going to put other wire. So viewers, you can see my second wire is not showing the continuity, it's showing the open circuit. So I will replace this wire and then check the result. My machine is okay, so no okay, so it's mean my one wire have a somewhere problem. Okay, so viewers, here was the problem, here wire, this wire was broken. Now I have put another wire. I replaced the wire. So now I'm going to check the machine is okay or not. So viewers, my now code has gone, and now my machine is ready to go for work. Okay, so now my machine is cleared.
In this way, I able to solve the problem. Hope you like this video. Don't forget to subscribe this channel and share this video to your friend.